extremo, 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 ah. extremo, extremo.
Ritmo.
Ritmo, sorry. Kiss FM. It's John J. Rich. Hey, so tonight at midnight starts Arizona Gives Day. Starts at midnight tonight. All donations can be made directly through the AZ Gives Day page. And there's a, you can donate to Love Pup. AZ Gives Day page, and there's special relief funding available due to COVID-19. Credit cards, debit cards, and e-checks are accepted. It's run by the Alliance of Arizona Nonprofits and Arizona Grantmakers. It started to help the community engage with support and support local nonprofits that play a critical role in our communities, and Love Pup is one of them. So azgives.org. It starts tonight at midnight. So we'll be posting stuff on social media and everything. Now, speaking of Love Pup, AZ Pet Vet is a huge supporter of Love Pup. I mean, they get, you know, when people always, when we pick up dogs all around the city, a lot, we'll pick up a dog or someone drops off a dog, I have them go to AZ Pet Vet because they got a whole bunch of locations. And Dr. Wayne Anderson, like, that's his baby. He's the genius behind AZ Pet Vet. So I thought it'd be kind of cool to get him on the air to talk about, because a lot of, you know, some places are closed, some of them are not. There's different things that are going on. So I thought it'd be great for him to get on the show. And so did Kyle. Actually, Kyle brought it up. Mm-hmm. So Dr. Anderson, you're on the air. Kiss FM, hello.
Hello, John Jay and everybody else. How are you doing this morning?
Good. Hey, so how many locations do you have open, and what's going on with, so how can people take their dogs and cats and rabbits in to get serviced?
Oh, yeah. Well, we're still open. We are essential, basically, for the dogs and cats. Nobody else is going to take care of them, and they are still getting sick at the same rate. So all 21 hospitals are open. We certainly have adjusted in this new environment, though. We are doing curbside service, and that's a little different. People call in and need to make an appointment, and they talk to the doctor then, pull up. And the staff member then goes out and retrieves the patient and goes into the hospital. And we're always in constant contact with the owners in their cars.
Are you surprised at all by that news out of New York about that tiger getting COVID? And has anybody else asked you about other pets that might be susceptible to that?
Well, that's been a question very early on, can dogs and cats? And this time, our national association, there's no evidence at all that virus can pass between pets and from pets to people. I know there are a couple domestic pets in China and one in Belgium, and then this thing with the tigers there in New York. But as of now, they're still looking at things. But with so much of this disease being worldwide, as of now, that does not seem to be a problem. And so that does get asked by a lot of our clients regularly, and that's where we are with that. So,
Dr. Anderson, I know that, you know, a lot of people have lost their jobs. A lot of people's paychecks have gone down. And so some people may say, well, my dog may be sick, but I got to feed my family. You guys actually work with people on payment plans, right?
Oh, yes, and that's been something we've done forever, but certainly now it is even more important for people. Veterinary medicine, there certainly is a cost to it, and we've realized that for years. And so at all our hospitals, we do no-interest payment plans, and they're very much client-to-client, we try to be very different with those as far as efficiency and selective. Each patient, we do something different. But now it's even more. We go out further, and these are no-interest payment plans, and it's something that we've done forever. So it certainly helps in this time, because we do want, and most clients want to do the best they can for their pet, and so we try to continue that if we can.
You know, I had no idea that you guys offered that, and I get asked that question all the time. That's great.
Oh, yeah.
That's great.
Well, we do. We get a lot of things from emergency clinics and specialty people where those fees are a little higher, certainly. And then we have a lot of talented doctors, truly, between the group. And so we get referrals from specialists and emergency clinics because they'll say, go to that group because they will help you. And help is the key word, meaning they'll help financially. But, again, we have a lot of really, I'm fortunate, we have a lot of talented doctors in this group. And I wanted to bring up one thing. Our staff, the front people, the certified technicians, the assistants, the kennel people, they're the ones on the front line, and they are working so hard during this thing, and we've had to come up with whole new policies and procedures. We don't know exactly how to go out to the car and do that, but they're every day it seems like someone is giving a good idea, and that spreads out through all the hospitals. Again, it's a work in progress on how we're going to do this, and it seems to be this is going to be around for a while. So we're still seeing things. If a client is concerned, we're concerned. So there are some basic things we might be pushing out. But until we see it, we really don't know. So we just as soon have the client call us and then maybe drop by and we can evaluate things. But again, we're concerned. That's what we do, the business we're in.
What are the times that you guys are open?
Oh, we're open 7:30 morning till 7 at night, and then we're open till 3 on both Saturday and Sunday. So we're open 7 days a week.
All right,
always
so
have been.
What's a website for you?
If you go to azpetvet.com, anyone, and type in your zip code, you'll come up with the practices that are closer to you. And we're pretty well all over the valley. We are in out East Mesa, Signal Butte, and we're in Buckeye, Anthem, and Phoenix, Glendale, Surprise, Peoria. We're kind of all over. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I know you come to Central Phoenix yourself.
Yeah, I'm there on the 16th of Madison, yep. Whatchamacallit, Animal Hospital.
Yep. Yeah. Yep.
Thank you, Dr. Wayne. Thanks for being on the program.
Hey, well, thank you so much, and good luck with the Love Pup and the foundation. We really do support that and think you're doing great work there.
Thank you. Yeah, you guys are amazing, actually. We couldn't do a lot of it without you. You guys are amazing.
Well, right. Thank you, everybody. Be safe.
Dr. Wayne Anderson. He keeps trying to get me to go in for a surgery. No, I mean, not for me, to watch a surgery.
Oh,
that's different.
I know. I was like, yeah, yeah.
What would he like to perform on you?
Get neutered. Anyway, that's amazing. Again, by the way, if you missed earlier, we're talking about we have access to the Easter Bunny. We want the Easter Bunny to come through a neighborhood with a bunch of kids. So if you know where there's a bunch of kids, and it could be tomorrow.